Hi, I'm Himacha Sunkara. I'm a customer success technical architect here at MuleSoft. As part of the Friends of Max video series, today we are going to discuss about API functional monitoring. We shall first discuss about what an API functional monitor is, when do we use it, and how to create a basic API functional monitor. Before getting started and diving into how-to specifics of creating a functional monitor, let us first discuss what an API functional monitor is. An API functional monitoring is a framework for ensuring the quality and reliability of your public and private APIs that are being used in your application networks. Let's say you have a critical API which you want to monitor regularly and check the health of the API, like if the API is up and running or if the API is responding to the request that you're sending on its endpoints. That is when you could go ahead and create an API functional monitor for your critical API. So let's get started and see how to create a functional monitor. Once you log into the AnyPoint platform, click on the main menu on the left side. Before creating a functional monitor, you first need to deploy an application with a basic endpoint. So let's go into the runtime manager first. So I've already deployed a couple of basic endpoint applications. So this is the Mule process account API job with a basic HTTP endpoint. So click on the manage application here. So if you already have an API which is already deployed, then you click on the manage application and select the enable monitoring and visualizer checkbox if you haven't already done it. So this is how you could actually, the AnyPoint monitoring can actually collect the metrics from your API. If you do not have any API deployed, then please go ahead and deploy an API. And don't forget to enable this checkbox while deploying this application. So as I've already deployed, I am just going to take the app URL or the host name for this particular API and go to monitoring to create a functional monitor. So this is AnyPoint monitoring page where you could find all the monitoring features. Functional monitoring is one of them. Click on the functional monitoring. So this is the functional monitoring page. Let's discuss what are the different ways that we have to in order to create a functional monitor. So you basically can do it in two ways. One is to create a functional monitor to the UI, AnyPoint platform UI that you have here. And the other way is to create a functional monitor in some code or text editors and upload that functional monitor using this upload button here. You could create this functional monitor in a BDD syntax. We are going to see how to create a functional monitor through the UI. Let's click on this create button and give some name to your functional monitor. Click on next. So these are different request editor types that you have. One is basic and the other one is advanced. If you have multiple endpoints and if you want to perform assertions for the response that you are getting from the API, then you could go ahead and click on advanced. The application which I have deployed has a HTTP basic endpoint. So I'm just going to go with basic and I'm going to select get. You could go ahead and select whatever the method that you would like to use for your API and give the endpoint URL or the host name. And select the expected status code. So I'm going to check if my API is going to give me a 200 OK or not. If you want to use any other response code which you are expecting from your API, you could go ahead and select one. And my API that I've deployed is not expecting any header information. So I'm just going to leave this headers, which is optional. If your API is expecting any header information, then go ahead and click on add header and give the keys and values. I'm not expecting anything, so I'm going to delete it. So select the location. I'm going to deploy my functional monitor in US East 1. You could go ahead and select whichever location that you would like to deploy this functional monitor in. You could go ahead and create a private location as well. Select the schedule for the functional monitor to run. I'm going to check if my API is up and running every 15 minutes. You could go ahead and select whatever schedule that you would like your API to run in and click on next. So here you could add a reporter for your functional monitor. So this is the best part of functional monitoring. So there are five different systems which are integrated with functional monitoring here: Slack, PagerDuty, New Relic, Sumo Logic, and email. So you could go ahead and select whichever system that you have. So say if you have a Slack, just select Slack and give the webhook link and click on create to create a functional monitor. So if you do not have any of these systems available, then you could go ahead and create or select an email. So I've given my email ID and click on enter and click on the create. So once you click on the create button, this is the page that you can see. This is the monitor that we have created just now. Let's wait until there is at least one run before we get into each one of these tabs and see what all information that we could get from this dashboard. I wanted to run at least a few times in order to show you the history. So I'm just clicking on run now button and run it. If you do not click on run now, it will follow the schedule that we have given there. That is 15 minutes and ping this API every 15 minutes. So there are at least two to three executions. So let's see what each one of this tab has. So click on the monitored endpoints. This is where you could actually see the status if it is passed or failed and the endpoint of that API that we have given, that we have configured while creating a monitor, and what is the minimum response time and what is the average response time and the maximum response time. Click on the test, and this is where you could find options. If you want to delete this monitor, you could do so, and if you want to edit, click on the edit and you can always go ahead and click, select or change anything. And if you want to download this test, you could go ahead and click on the download. And if you want to see the history for your last few executions, you could go ahead and click on history, where you can actually see the history of the functional monitors. So if you want to understand how to more about this particular run, click on the details, where you could see the status, what is the in how much time that you got the response, and the method and the path, and what type of API this is. This is a HTTP API, and you could go ahead and download this as well. And here in the schedules tab, if you click on the schedules tab, you can see when is the next run going to be. This is going to be in next 11 minutes. And what is the schedule that we have configured? We have configured every 15 minutes and the version of this monitor and in which location that we have deployed this monitor. You could go ahead and always modify, delete, or disable this scheduler. You can also see the information, the dashboard for this particular monitor, and also see how you're getting the past or error status here. Our first two executions were successful. The third one has been failed. As soon as there is any error, you will get a notification email sent to your email ID that you have configured while creating the monitor. So this is how the email notification looks like. So I got a 404, which is not equal to 200, which I've selected as my expected response code. So I've got an email notification email saying that account monitor has failed. You can find more information about functional monitors here. And how to create custom monitors as well at docs.mulesoft.com/API functional monitoring.
Thank you for watching API functional monitoring video tutorial. See you in the next tutorial.